That was a long time ago. We don't have any plastic bag. And every single time we go to the beach, we find any like a plastic bottle or something, that we are very happy. We thought that's not gonna be bad for the future. But finally, time to time, when the tourism start to set up like 1985 here, we start to see like one by one the plastic coming. The pollution was like a really very big impact for animal in the water, animal on the land. So every single rainy season we have here, we always have a lot of plastic underwater. Especially we have been seeing that turtle was been struggling by the plastic bag. For me, it's like a plastic is completely bad. In Indonesia, maybe just only 15 or 20% of people are very aware of how to throw the trash properly. Most of the local people, when they're going to market, they get more plastic than they put. So normally the people like, okay, just like, okay, take the food, throwing the plastic, I don't care anymore.
Saya masuk di Gili Trawangan tahun 70, tidak ada plastik. Kalau dulu pakai daun pisang. Semua itu dibungkus dengan plastik. Yang dimakan dibungkus, yang dipakai baju apa segala pakai plastik semua. Kala pembakaran sampah itu karena lebih banyak sampahnya daripada.
Saya tinggal di Pulau Lele Island. Banyak penduduk sana. Sampah banyak sekali di sana. Mas saya di sini orang di sini kota tidak mau kasih tempat sampah. Tidak ada tempat sampah, makanya dia buang di laut. Seharusnya dilarang itu. Harusnya ada yang bantu sama pemerintah.
Tidak ada bensin. Kalau yang kering-kering kayak plastik apa dibakar? Karena penanggulan sampahnya di sini hanya di sini saja. Bermasalah buat saya karena tidak pernah habis. Dibakar ada lagi lebih banyak lagi bakar seterusnya.
The people the burning the garbage because it doesn't have any education for know about like okay how toxic the plastic. They only teach you throw your trash to the bin. But if you don't have a bin there, they never tell you don't throw to the ground. What I want from the government is education. We need the example because now like even like our president or our governor, I still see them carrying the plastic bag. It's not that just only giving the law, we have to show our people.
Situasi di Babrawa Beach pada saat polutris atau plastiknya banyak, kita memerlukan banyak tim untuk melakukan pembersihan pantai dari pagi sampai siang hari.
Me personally and also my team, we always doing beach cleaning every Friday because if Bali is not clean and green, there will be no one coming over to our island. We don't want our paradise is hiding behind the trash bin.
This is my place. Name of this place is Brotherhood. Okay, this project completely rebuilt with zero money. All the material we have in is just only like a dump on the people place, and then I just asking can I use, and then they give, and then I just start the building. Nah, kita bikin bunga ya. Nah,
ini bunga apa?
Ini bunga putih. Plastic straw ya. Ya, plastic straw. This is the plastic bag. The motivation for me to build this one is like I want to educate all the kids of the Gili Meno. Because our kids is our future. We make a book for Gili Meno kids. We bring like water refill for the kids. And then we pretend them like not using plastic straw, plastic bottle, plastic bag. And then also not only kids, but also we educate the people like living on the island to not really dump the plastic everywhere. We don't try to change like 100% no one allowed to bring the plastic here, but at least we can make less to use the plastic on the island. Because starting from one small thing you do, they can impact you to a big thing.